So now the second paragraph for the question number 40, 51 and 52, there is a line which is given that parallel to y-axis and k units away from the y-axis in right side, let this is intersect the x-axis at the point k comma 0. If this line is rotated in clockwise direction and after 1 minute it is given that this forms an isosceles triangle with x-axis. So let in that situation the point A is k comma 0 and point B is 0 comma minus k. So triangle OAB is isosceles triangle. That's why given that centroid of this triangle is 2 comma minus 2. So from this data, x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3 is equals to 2. So k by 3 is equals to 2. K becomes 6. So we can conclude that A is 6 comma 0. Now, angular velocity of this rotation, because we know that after 1 minute this situation occurs, so after 1 minute the rotation of angle is for 45 degree, so that's why in per second rotation will be 3 by 4 degree per second. So for question number 51, we have to find the number of tangents if t is less than 4 before 4 minutes, means before rotation of 180 degree. We have to find the number of tangents for this circle if line is tangent. So we know that the situation of the circle is that center is 8,2 and the radius is 2. So that's why at the initial stage the line L is touching to this circle, and we know that this diagram it will touch again the circle after 90 degree rotation. So rotation of 90 degree will be after 2 minutes. So that's why answer of question number 51 will be the option B. Now in question number 42, we have to find the number of normals of y square equals to 24x when the line L is normal to the curve. So normal of this equation will be y is equals to mx minus 6m cube minus 12m, because we have to find that L is normal to this curve. So L is passing through a 6,0, that's why this normal should passes through 6,0. This will give you m is equals to 0, means there is a unique normal from the point A. That's why the solution of this equation before 4 minutes will be only one, and the answer of this question will be the option C. For the third paragraph, for the question number 53 and 54, there is a functional relation for the function fx is given for twice of fxy is equals to fx raised to power y plus fy raised to power fx x, and the given that is f1 is equals to k. So replace the value of y is equals to 1 in this functional relation will give you fx is equals to k power x, and the other function gx is defined that by fx upon 1 plus fx whole square, which is kx by 1 plus k power 2x. So for the question number 53, we have to find the limit twice of gx minus fx upon x as x approaches to 0. So replace the gx and fx, this will give us kx into 1 minus k power 2x upon x into 1 plus k power 2x. Replace the value of x in these two expressions will give you 1 by 2, and the remaining is limit give you the minus twice of ln k. So final result will be the minus ln k, and which is the option D. Now in the question number 54, we have to find the limit as n tends to infinity product from r is equals to 1 to n fr raised to power 1 by n square. Replace the value of r as well as n, this will give us k into k square k cube till k power n upon 1 by n power 1 by n square, and this becomes k raised to power 1 plus 2 plus 3 till n sum of n natural numbers, which is n into n plus 1 by 2 and power 1 by n square. If we replace n tends to infinity, so limit of n tends to infinity of this expression will be equals to half. That's why the final result will be k raised to power half, which is the option B in the question. So answer to 53 and 54 will be option D and option B. Now in the last paragraph, there is a sketch and some functions are defined according to this. These two are tangent to the point PQ of this arc. So by the triangle POS, we can conclude that because this radius is 1 given, so PS is equals to sine of x by 2, and by the triangle PSR, we can conclude that length SR is equals to 10 x by 2 sine x by 2. So hence for the question number 55, fx means area of triangle PQR becomes sine square x by 2 into 10 x by 2. Derivative, first derivative of this function will be this one, sine x by 2 cos x by 2 tan x by 2, and half sine square x by 2 sec square x by 2. After differentiating it again, this becomes the result, which is positive for all values of x belongs to 0 to pi by 0 to pi, because for if x is 0 to pi, x by 2 will be in the first quadrant, all ratios are positive, the expression will be positive. That's why the function is concave upwards, means all tangents are below the curve. So option B is correct for this question. Now in question number 56, area of this shaded region will be equals to gx, and this will be equals to area of this section arc and area of triangle OPQ, and this will be x by 2 minus half sine x by 2. After differentiating this gx, we can find 1 by 4 into 2 minus cos x by 2 will which will be always positive for x belongs to 0 to pi. It means gx is an increasing function in this interval, so that's why option A is correct.